This is a lesson to all of us, lah. You see, even when we want to do noble things, when we intend noble things, the manner in which we do things, we always have to be careful. You see, even in this video, at that point of time, you see the tinge of arrogance in the way PMX promised. Masa tu belum jadi PM lagi. Kita mesti, kita tak boleh. Kau tak boleh tak pijak bumi Sarawak. The words are arrogant. Because at the end of the day, whatever we do, with all must always be with the kalimah, insyaAllah. If Allah permits, you akan, when the time comes, when you get power, or when the time comes, at the material time, whatever you say you will or you won't, you may have to swallow your words because of circumstances. And at the end of the day, you can plan whatever, but Allah will always show you who is the real master planner. Nampak tak? All of us, the subjects are entertainment for Allah. Jadi bila kita kata macam tu, macam ni, learn. I also learn from this. I tengok pun, I reflect because I also do this sort of things and I am afraid now. Because at the end of the day, jangan confirm sangat that I will never take duit rakyat. I will never go rasuah. I will never be racist. I will never, I will always be like you when you say, I will always. I never will. You know, these sort of things, we say this. We are manifesting arrogance without even realizing it. We think we are being noble.
Kita menang. Ini hari kita menang. Dengar, tengok saya betul-betul. Nama saya Anwar Ibrahim. Tengok betul-betul. Tengok betul-betul. Saya penjara sudah, kena pukul sudah, kena telanjang, kena sudah, kena maki tiap-tiap malam. Jadi saya berani lawan, ya tau. You nak mau beli? Jadi kalau tanya saya, kalau saya cakap, setuju tak apa, tapi dengar. Apa guna saya? Pemangku Perdana Menteri pun sudah masuk jin. Okey, baik. Saya kata, ini hari menang, esok angkat sumpah, kasih saya 24 jam, saya turun harga minyak seluruh negara. Ingat, Dato' Najib berani turun. Ya. Dia mau jadi ketua mesti berani. Ya. Mau jadi ketua, mesti berani. Clean. Orang rompak, tangkap. Orang curi kena dia tanah, tangkap. Baru boleh jadi pemimpin. Royalty minyak kita bagi balik kepada Sarawak 20%. Ya. Boleh buat. Anak kita mau belajar. Sekarang hutang. Anak orang kaya, tak apalah. Bilion-bilion, balak diangkat, saham diangkat, beras diangkat, gula diangkat, elektrik diangkat, kita bayar. Anak dia mengaji, tak ada problem. Anak kita mau mengaji, bayar. Utang. Saya mau beritahu, anak Dayak ke, anak Melayu ke, anak Cina. Saya mau beritahu, anak kita. Anak Cina bukan semua token besar. Token besar jangan minta duit kepada kita. Orang Melayu ni tansri-tansri kaya-kaya jangan minta. Orang Iban pun 2-3 orang yang kaya-kaya punya. Jangan kacau kita. Tapi orang rakyat bawah, Dayak, Cina, Melayu, you belajar dari sekolah rendah sampai universiti, kita bagi free education. Yeah. Yeah. You buy, you hutang PTPTN, kita bakal punya hutang. Ya. Yeah. Kalau saya cakap, saya tak buat. Saya tak akan pijak Sarawak, you tahu tak? Ini jangan main-main, you tahu.
Jadi, bila jadi macam ni, you see how uncanny it is. Sekarang ni, nak turun minyak, tak boleh. Kena naikkan minyak because hutang negara teruk. And the subsidies that government is paying. Now, banyak orang marah diesel naik. I also get affected because now I pay banyak extra to fill up my family van, diesel. Tapi I know this is the right direction. Tapi the point at the backdrop of a promise that you akan turun minyak. Jadi orang marah. And this kind of videos will continue to be playing Sampailah the next election and this badani government, I look at it, one term government, done. Lepas tu bila you implement pula, you implement kat apa ni, Semenanjung saja, Sabah Sarawak, tak. The justification is merepek, justification. So even the way you roll out your plans pun masalah. And there's so much deception. Menipu, kata tadak ni, tadak perancangan, tak beretika reporting. Tapi last kali ada, you deny and then it's betul. You don't care about perception and credibility. You tak boleh lah, you cannot manage. Because dah teruk sangat dah, dah menggelabah sangat dah. Now problem is, not because what you can or cannot do. I know this government is trying to do their best. This is without a doubt. Tapi, given the backdrop of the arrogant promises that was made before, hapuskan ini, you as an opposition, you janji macam-macam, you are not privy to the finances and the hutang-hutang and the nonsense the previous government did. Bila dah ambil alih tampuk kuasa, dah tengok and you pegang finance ministry, you tengok bawah terkejut. You terkejut tengok apa jadi. And on top of that, you kena still pakai gloves. You can't whack those yang sapu because your partner is a kleptocrat party. Again, itu pun Allah arrange in such a way that you have to form a government with a kleptocrat party and you have to make concessions. That kita akan pergi pada orang yang korup, kita akan lawan korup semua, kita akan tangkap orang ni semua. Last kali orang-orang tu help you form government and you tak boleh tangkap dia orang. Nampak tak? All the promises of the opposition then, who is the government now, it was the arrogance in the way you promise thing as you commit. Azam Baki, bila ini kita cari kamu lah ni, you lantik, you naik dia. Tak boleh, you tak boleh buat apa dah, because at the end of the day, you are so sure you want to lawan orang. You are so sure. Tengok macam Zahid. No, UMNO. No, UMNO. Last kali, macam mana? Apa jadi? Whatever you say, you have to backpedal. Now, this backpedaling, orang kata you menipu lah. You kata dulu macam ni, tapi you buat you menipu. Tapi the point is, I can feel orang-orang yang dituduh menipu ni, dia rasa macam mana? Dia bukan niat nak menipu. Dia bukan niat nak menipu. Tetapi circumstance in such a way, it looks like that. Now, kalau I jadi dia orang, I learn my lesson. Kalau lepas ni jadi opposition also should learn the lesson. Faham tak? Macam PAS, macam apa semua tu. PAS pun ada yang memang menipu. Tapi PAS ada juga yang janji betul. Tapi last sekali, tak terbuat. The hudud apa semua tu tak boleh. Tak terbuat because you over promise. You cakap dalam mulut tu, insya Allah, mulut, lip service. Tapi you don't manifest, insya Allah. Whatever you say, I will kapai. Kalau Allah permits, because Allah can always turn the situation in such a way that you cannot. It is beyond your mortal perception. Therefore, you know, kalau kita betul-betul beriman, bertakwa, we are measured in everything we say. We don't use the word will, never, always, definitely, certainly, these kind of things. The more of these words comes out from you, it shows how devoid you are of iman. I say this to remind even myself. I also talk like this sometimes, but the first step is being aware. Be aware and so that you know, Allah tak test us to that extent. The trials and tribulation that Allah can place on us, sometimes tak sanggup, tak boleh carry. Kalau tak sedap, kalau kita tak sedap benda ni, kita tak tahu, kita will continue go this way. Yang buat semua ni bukan muda-muda. At least, you know, 40, 50, 60. Dah tua, but did not learn. Now learn. Because whatever is happening today, is a lesson by Allah to everybody. To everybody in power, to everybody not in power, pada rakyat-rakyat, semua kita tengok, kita jangan sure sangat. Ada yang kata, you know, memang Madani government is the best lah. Last kali, you tengok apa jadi. Ada yang kata, this one term, tak mau lagi dah. How do you know? Ujung period, maybe things become better ataupun another alternative government is going to be so bad. Jangan sure sangat. Do everything dengan be measured, be objective, be humble in kita punya decisions. Jangan arrogantly decide here, decide there. You know, whatever lessons by God to this government or whatever, doesn't mean those lessons doesn't apply to us tau. Jadi kita berjaga-jagalah, jangan sure sangat. Oh, kalau this ni habislah kita jadi Taliban. Kalau kita buat macam ni, kita jadi habislah tak Islam dah. Kita jadi Yahudi. Kita jadi all this, the certainty in our assertions, that to me is arrogant. When we say these things, we do these things arrogant. In my life, I've said many these kind of things. And I learned a very painful lesson. I learned a humiliating lesson. But I'm in good state now, and I thank God for it, because I get to learn this. I used to judge people doing certain things, and later I do those things. And when I do those things, I understand the circumstance of why I had to do those things, and then people judge me. Nampak tak? This kind of things, you know, what goes around comes around. Karma is very real. Jadi, I tengok, in a way, I also pity this government lah. Dia bukan niat menipu. Tapi circumstance happen and they don't even know how to go about it. Kalau dah jadi macam ni, you dah nampak benda tu. If your problem was promising dulu, be honest to the rakyat. Tell them, we promise macam tu, we did not know. Explain. It's not kelemahan. It's not weakness to show your oversight. It is courage and honesty to admit what went wrong, what you're wrong, to explain bagi understand. Orang percaya tak percaya, tak apalah. But you explain clearly and open semua. Telanjang bokeh. Tunjuk kat orang yang, you know, you are sincere. Jadi people may forgive you. Show the sincerity of the government to the people. You tak tunjuk sincere, you want to stay on your high horse. You kata tak payah cerita yang ni, you nak buat apa you suka. You don't know what the effect is tau. The misgivings will be the final nail in your coffin come next GE. This government, you know, maybe underestimate. Tapi never underestimate the power of the rakyat. Don't forget, you guys were Pakatan Rakyat dulu. Means the momentum begin with Pakatan Rakyat, then became Pakatan Harapan. You brought down a very evil draconian regime that never could have come down, but you did that by the power of the rakyat. Jadi jangan lupa what the rakyat can do, the tsunami of change the rakyat can wield. You don't underestimate. Jadi kalau macam ni, things are turned against you, masuk next GE, you lose power, you may never come back to power ever again. It will be the coffin, the burial ground of your political careers. Jadi, I hope, I don't know how many people will resonate with this. Tapi kalau tak mau learn, tak apalah. You want to learn the hard way, learn the hard way. Tapi siapa yang dah learn the hard way, at least share, bagi orang, enlighten people to make a better Malaysia. Assalamualaikum.
If you want to see more content like this, make sure to like, share, subscribe, and hit the bell notification so you don't miss any new videos. Yes.